Good afternoon. My name is Olivia Mauger, and I'm on the Dell Server Technical Marketing team. Today, I'm here with Sujin Liu, who is the product manager for the PowerEdge entry rack and tower servers. And today, we are super excited to discuss the launch of the latest servers that are joining the PowerEdge family, which is the T360 and R360. So to kick us off, Sujin, can you explain who these servers are designed for?
Sure. Thank you, Olivia. My name is Sujin, and I'm the product manager for R360 and T360. It's my pleasure, and I'm very excited today to introduce this new servers to you. So the T360 and R360 are cost-effective one-socket servers. We targeted for the small to medium business with a growing computing demand. They can be deployed in the remote or branch office, in near edge, or in a typical data analytic environment. The biggest difference between the T360 and R360 is their form factor. The T360 is a tower server that can fit under a desk or even in a storage cabinet while maintaining office-friendly acoustic. And on the other hand, the R360 is a more traditional one-U rack server.
Awesome. So that definitely gives a good picture of how they are similar, but also different, namely, like you said, in form factor. So now let's dig into it a little bit deeper. And can you tell me about key tech upgrades from the previous generation that are now included in these two new servers?
Absolutely. First of all, both the servers support the latest Intel Xeon E processors that just launched. And also we support the DDR5 memory up to 128 GB, NVMe both, and the PCIe Gen 5 input and output ports. And another biggest improvement on these two platforms are the supportabilities of, you know, one NVIDIA A2 GPU. This is the first generation we support GPU on the entry one socket platforms, because we have seen a growing demand for video and audio computing, particularly in the retail, manufacturing, and logistic industries. This entry data center GPU will accelerate this media intensive workload, as well as the emerging AI workload. For example, a retailer could leverage the power of the A2 GPU and the latest CPU to stream video of the store aisles for inventory management and customer behavior analytics. And Olivia, I know you have done a great testing on these two platforms, and you have a great result to share. Would you talk more about it?
Absolutely. And the testing we did primarily focused on comparing the prior generation servers to the new T and R360. And I've namely, I'll give three callouts. One is for database workloads. We saw up to 50% better performance. And this performance for databases especially is critical for businesses that handle large volumes of customer data and complex queries. And if we go back to our discussion on the added GPU support, the PowerEdge R360 put in one NVIDIA A2 GPU and got 5 times better performance for a 3D modeling workload compared to that same workload run only on CPU. And this benchmark was the publicly available Blender benchmark, and it allowed us to render images just on GPU and then only on CPU. And so this would correspond to use case where there's heavy 3D modeling and simulation. And lastly, you mentioned a couple times the release of the latest Intel E2400 series processors. So a performance lab at Dell ran the industry standard spec benchmark on the T and R360 and gotten really impressive results. You can see anywhere between 30 to 80% better CPU performance alone on these various workloads. So really, you know, whether it's databases, 3D modeling, leveraging the new GPU and the CPU performance, it really speaks to how much of an upgrade these servers are.
Thank you, Olivia. That's very impressive results. And I hear a lot of data like 50%, 5 times, up to 80%. I think all the data tells us reason why business and customers would benefit from upgrading to this new service. And also, Olivia, can you tell our customer where to find more details on these test results?
Absolutely. The papers that give more details about the testing configurations and benchmark details are linked in this video description. And Spec CPU results are actually publicly available on spec.org, so you can check them out there. And I really just wanted to thank you, Sujin, for participating in this tech talk, and who better to hear from about the launch of these two new servers. And I'm really excited to see how these performance gains translates to use cases for our customers.
Thank you. Thank you, Olivia, for inviting me. And also, I'm very excited and feel great to show all the new technologies on these two platforms to you. And thanks for watching. You can go to dell.com to check more details and find the new platforms there. Thank you.